Have you ever wondered what the world looks like through your dog's eyes? We've all heard about their black and white vision, a myth that recent studies have debunked. But that doesn't change the fact that our furry friends perceive colors and movement very differently from us humans. In this video, we're going to talk about the quirks of dog vision and how you can use that knowledge to build a stronger bond with your furry friends. Also, you'll find out if your beloved companion has any genetic sight issues that you should worry about. But first, how much do dogs actually rely on their vision? Some might say dogs view the world through their nose. Their sense of smell is so powerful that they can detect a teaspoon of sugar in a million gallons of water, roughly equivalent to two Olympic-sized swimming pools. Their next strongest sense is an incredible ability to detect frequencies up to 65,000 hertz, allowing them to hear sounds that are entirely inaudible to us, such as the tiny rustling of a mouse in the grass. So, what about their vision? How much do our furry friends rely on it, and how similar is it to human vision? Dogs and humans have a similar position of the eyes, and the size of the eyes in proportion to the head is also quite similar, making dogs more like us than other animals such as horses, birds, or insects. Still, researchers have found some fascinating differences in the quality of a dog's vision when compared to humans. Let's settle once and for all which colors dogs can actually see. Generally speaking, there are two types of light receptors in the eyes, cones and rods. Humans have three types of cone cells in their eyes, each sensitive to different wavelengths of light: red, blue, and green. This vision enables us to see a wide spectrum of colors, including the vibrant hues that make our world so colorful. However, dogs have just two types of cone cells, meaning they don't perceive the world in the vibrant colors that we see. For example, they don't notice the difference in the colors of grass that they enjoy so much, or that bright red ball you're throwing to them. It's more like a shade of brown or gray. Interestingly, a lot of dog accessories are made in colors that dogs absolutely cannot distinguish: green, red, pink, and purple. These colors are supposed to catch our eye, not that of our dogs. So, what colors do our furry friends actually see? Recent studies suggest that those colors are quite surprisingly blue and yellow. So next time you're picking a toy or accessory for your furry pal, stick two shades of blue or yellow. These colors stand out to them the most, making playtime more exciting and engaging from their perspective. While dogs might not see a rainbow like we humans, they have a unique way of differentiating between certain shades of colors. During a fascinating study, researchers presented dogs with three light panels, two of the same color and one different. Through this experiment, it was discovered that dogs can reliably tell the difference between shades of colors. For example, they won't mistake a light yellow object for a dark yellow one. Unlike cones, rods, the other light receptor is more abundant in a dog's eye than in a human's. A higher concentration of rods in their eyes gives dogs a remarkable ability to distinguish between different grays. In one fascinating study, researchers tested dogs by showing them images on screens, gradually altering the shades of gray. The dogs were able to pick out even the slightest differences in shade, much like how we might spot a friend in a dimly lit room. Here's a fun life hack. When playing hide and seek with your dog indoors, hide in a spot with varying shades of gray, like near a gray sofa or on a pattern rug. It'll be a fun challenge for them to use their gray detecting skills to find you. And here's another fun fact. Their grayscale vision helps dogs immensely in low light conditions, like during dawn or dusk, making them excellent companions for night walks thanks to a special layer in their eyes called the tapetum lucidum, which acts like a mirror reflecting light at the back of their eyes. When we talk about visual acuity, we're essentially discussing the clarity or sharpness of vision. Dogs have only about 20% of the visual acuity that humans do, meaning what we see clearly, they see more like a blurred image. Think of it this way. If a human can clearly read the letters on an eye chart from 20 feet away, a dog would need to be just 4 feet away to see the same level of detail. Their world is a bit like looking through a lens that's not quite focused. But why is this the case? It's all about survival. Over the years, a dog's vision has adapted to be more efficient in detecting motion and seeing in low light rather than focusing on fine details. For instance, if your dog doesn't immediately recognize you from a distance, it's not that they're ignoring you, but rather that they might not see you clearly until you're closer. But wait until you find out about the dog's incredible ability to detect motion. Scientists tested dogs' ability to distinguish between objects at various distances and found that dogs are much better at noticing moving objects than static ones, especially at a distance. This ability comes from their days as hunters, where spotting and tracking subtle movements of prey was crucial for survival. So, if your dog suddenly starts sprinting for something, they might have detected a squirrel or another small animal that our human eye would have no hope of detecting. But how can we use this knowledge to form a better bond with our furry pals? When playing with your dog or training them, use large moving toys. They're much more likely to catch your dog's attention than small or stationary ones. Also, use toys that move unpredictably. This will stimulate your dog's natural hunting instincts and keep them engaged during playtime. Did you know that the quality of vision can vary significantly among different dog breeds? It's a fascinating aspect that often goes unnoticed. For instance, breeds like Greyhounds and Siberian Huskies, known for their speed and endurance, typically have better long-distance vision. This trait was essential for their ancestral roles in hunting and sledding, where spotting objects from afar was crucial. On the other hand, breeds like pugs and bulldogs, with their shorter snouts and more forward-facing eyes, might have a wider field of vision up close but can be more prone to nearsightedness or myopia. The reason behind the predisposition of certain dog breeds to myopia is not entirely clear, but it's believed to be related to the specific tasks and environments these breeds were historically developed for. German Shepherds, renowned for their roles in police and military work, possess a remarkable balance of both distant and close-up vision. Their eyes are adept at following fast-moving objects, which is crucial in high-stakes situations like search and rescue operations or tracking. Rottweilers, historically trained as guard dogs to detect potential threats or changes in their immediate environment, might have a focus on close vision acuity, which might be the reason behind their nearsightedness. So, what's the life hack here for dog owners? If you have a breed prone to nearsightedness, make sure their play area is well lit and their toys are large and close enough for them to see clearly for breeds with better.